How to get SAP system access as following the practice of SAP ABAP. We need the system access where we can do the practice of SAP ABAP coding. So for getting the system access, here I will show three methods. One is like the remote desktop connection, that is called as the RDP access, that is called as remote desktop protocol. We can get this service by the official website of SAP, cal.sap.com. They charge on the hourly basis for giving the access, or we can search on Google. There are many service providers available in the market who can provide us SAP server access for the practice. So first we'll see about the remote desktop connection, that is RDP. Then we'll see about the server access from local PC laptop. And third one, like the mini SAP installation, we can install the SAP in our own laptop. But the mini SAP laptop, this gives very limited features. So preferred methods for server access, either first one or the second one. Now we'll see in details how it works in the first method and the second method. In case of remote desktop connection, that is the RDP access that can be purchased from the cal.sap.com or other service provider. They charge on monthly basis and the SAP Cal charge on the hourly basis. In this scenario, so instead of our laptop, basically by typing a MSTSC command, we go to a remote desktop connection. The service provider or the SAP Cal through the Amazon services, they give us access of the remote desktop connection. There we have to enter the IP address. After entering the IP address, we can go into the remote desktop. This is like instead of our laptop, we are going logging into some other laptop, which is a remote location. Here we have to enter the ID and password. Then this arrow we have to click. Once you click on that arrow, so we can see another laptop screen that is already pre-configured and ready to use for SAP. So to access SAP on that screen, we can see an icon called as SAP logon. We have to double click on that logon. Then a pop-up will come, and generally there are multiple servers available inside the SAP logon. This is called as a GUI. This icon is called as the SAP GUI, graphical user interface. So based on the server details for which they have provided us the access, we have to double click on that server name. Inside connection, you can see server name. So we have to double click on this. After double click, again we can see a screen for the login. The first one was for the remote desktop login, and this is for the actual SAP login. Here we have to give the user ID and the password, which the service provider will give us. By default, one client will come. But if your service provider is giving access of different client, accordingly you have to change. So once we enter the ID password here, then finally we can reach to SAP screen from where we can do our development. This is called the SAP Easy Access, which consists of multiple items that we'll see in details. That is menu, toolbar, is called a SAP menu. This is basically divided just like a folder. If you want to perform the logistics related operations, we have to expand this folder for accounting related. For SAP ABAP, we generally use the tools. So this method we have seen using the RDP. In this case, we don't have to install any software on our local laptop or PC because we are logging to some other system. So let's see in detail how it works exactly. If I enter MSTSC in my local laptop. This screen get come up. Here you have to enter the IP address given by service provider and click on connect. On this screen we have to enter our user ID and password. Like here I am entering my ID and password which they have given to me and click on this arrow. Once we come inside this screen, so we can see the SAP logon icon is there. This means that they have installed the SAP GUI in the system. It is ready to use. We have to double click here. And you can see different servers are already, connections for different servers already created. If you want to add any new server, you have to select connections and click on new. Click on next. Then here you have to give the description, the application server, that is IP address, instance number, system ID and SAP router string. But as we are already using the RDP connection, so everything they pre-configured for us. We just have to double click here. And we can enter ID password which they provide to us. Once we enter, so we can see the SAP logo on the screen. So on top, this is called a menu bar. This is the toolbar. And this is called a SAP menu. Suppose you want to go into logistic application, then we'll expand the logistics. Material management, you can say purchasing, master data. And you can see the all the items related to the purchase order. So like this, as per our requirement, we can go to a particular hierarchical form. For ABAP, we use these tools. Expander tools, ABAP workbench, overview, SCAT. Those are all called the transaction code. On the left hand side is called transaction code. The right hand side, this is the description. A transaction code nothing but like instead of going through the by expanding the each folder, you can directly enter this transaction code in this command. Like here, if I double click on SCAT, system, navigate to my new screen, that is a back workbench. But same, instead of going so deep level, I can just enter at the top here and I can enter the T code as AC80. A transaction code is nothing but the short code to access an application. So if I enter SCAT at the top, we can see the same screen. So all the applications, either we can go through the SAP navigation by expanding the folders, or if you know the T code, directly enter T code at the top level. So this is about getting the SAP access through RDP, that is remote desktop connection. Now the next option is server access. In this case, the SAP is installed at a remote location in the server, and from our laptop we can access the server. In this case, we are not going to log in into the RDP connection. But for this, first we have to install the GUI that we can get from the service provider, or we can download from the internet, that is called as SAP GUI, SAP GUI. The SAP GUI comes with different versions. Already install the latest one. Always install the latest one. So in this case, your service provider or through net, you will get this file, that is the installation file. Just like other software which we install in our local laptop. So they also provide a installation folder file. Once you go inside that, you will find different files and also SAP setup guide is given. You can refer to the SAP setup guide and accordingly you can install the SAP GUI on your laptop. After installation, again, same which we have seen in the RDP, we'll able to see a SAP logon shortcut on the screen. But here in case of RDP, it was already configured. We have not added any connection details here. But if you are installing GUI with your own, then after getting this icon, we have to click on new or create a new entry, and service provider will give us the IP address of the application server, the instance number and system ID. That all we have to enter here, and we have to click on finish. Then we'll able to log on to the server. So this was the second method. Third method is like mini SAP installation on our old laptop. So instead of RDP access or getting server access from service provider, we can install SAP on our own laptop. There are some prerequisites about the like requirement of RAM, requirement of hard disk. This you can get details to the website gogo.support.sap.com/mini-sap. But this comes with very limited features. Like the standard module FI, SD, MM doesn't come. But for normal practice, you can use this SAP Mini. Once you go to the website, you can see there trials and downloads. Click on this and follow the instructions which are given. But the preferred method will be the first two method. Generally, all use first two method, remote desktop connection, RDP access, or the second one. The second one is very popular. And also, suppose if you are already working in a company who is already SAPing, using SAP, so you can use your own server for the practice. If you are not working and you want to SAP access, then you can use one of the methods from these three. So this is all about getting the SAP access for practice.